we are laying off teachers and shutting down elements of public health and reducing our housing subsidies in order to pay mostly for acute medical costs. So this is the rate of inflation of acute medical costs in my state, Massachusetts, and everything else that a state does is actually going down. That is not a sustainable situation. We need tactics that will successfully reduce the rate of growth of the cost of care. I will say the external pressures, the federal government, the state government, and the commercial insurers would say to us, tomorrow is not soon enough for you to fix this problem. When we turn around to the people delivering care, they say, you know, you can't shut down, retool, and then restart the factory. You've got to be delivering care as you change care. And my job is to balance those two competing forces. And by the way, I know when I'm doing okay when I'm failing at both of those, right? When you sign a contract that holds you accountable for money, like a lot of money, and spending it wisely, your thinking becomes a little clearer when next year's budget actually depends on meeting a cost reduction target this year. We were organized right from the board all the way down through the management structures to deliver volume, because that's how we got paid. We signed contracts that said, actually, volume is bad, and we were asking our chief financial officers at all the different organizations within our umbrella, you now have your performance is based on two spreadsheets. And by the way, if you're doing better at one, you're probably doing worse on the other, right? And so the response back from the CFOs was, well, how do you propose we do that? I'd say we have a direction, but we don't have an answer. But our work falls into three basic buckets. Network composition, who do we need inside this ACO in order to make progress? How do we flow the incentives? We call that the internal performance framework. And then very specifically, the investment in population health management infrastructure. This is what you're doing to actually change care. We have 350,000 people under commercial contracts, 30,000 in Medicaid, 100,000 in Medicare, and then we self-insure for our own employees. That means that 60% of our primary care patients are in risk contracts. That means that when we design the delivery of primary care, we are designing them for risk contracts. If you are doing something difficult, you need to do something that's aspirational and appeal to the intrinsic motivation of the people who are actually with the patients. I don't know of any clinician who wouldn't want to deliver better care. They're just really cautious about someone else telling them what better care is. We had to have a whole series of retreats in our organizations to get to figure out what our strategy was. But it's our strategy. So we have partners healthcare, primary care, acute, post-acute, and specialty care. And we want to achieve the quadruple aim. And so then what we did is we said, how do we get from there to there? Well, the first thing we did is we identified what we believe our largest opportunities to save money and improve patient care are. We came up with 10, and they go after the big cost drivers, unnecessary hospitalizations, unnecessary use of post-acute care, more use of home care, more use of primary care. And we just said, we're just going to start doing it. We don't know exactly how it's going to work, but we're going to just start doing these things. And we'll figure it out as we go. So we'll make progress, and that progress is measured against outcomes. At the bottom here, all this data and analytics that services these outcomes, but very importantly, these process measures. Because these process measures basically just say, are you putting this in place, and are you making progress? Are you delivering on it? Like, are you getting the work done? And then the outcomes measures say, is the work producing the result you want? And if it's not, then you've got to go back to rejigger it. A lot of these things we put in place, we did not get the outcome we were hoping for at first, but we fixed it. You go back and you say, we learned some lessons, we go back and we fix it. It's the commitment to the journey and not the commitment to exactly the way you designed it to launch it, that was critically important. And then we have some evidence that we're actually achieving the triple aim with this. We have some of our programs our primary care doctors absolutely love, our care management program. We've saved over $50 million on an annual basis this year. We are expecting 2 years from now to be saving $100 million annually. That's our goal. And we're doing it because we're replacing the way we delivered care before more and more with much more efficient ways of delivering care, using a lot of technology to enable that more efficient delivery.